brachial plexus. It is the network of nerves which supplies the upper limb. Root value: anterior primary rami of C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1 spinal nerves. Stages of brachial plexus: there are root stage, trunk stage, division stage, cord stage and branches. So there are totally 5 stages in the brachial plexus. Number 1, root stage. It is formed by the apex of C5 to T1 spinal nerves. Sometimes the C5 is absent and T2 joins to form the brachial plexus. This is known as post-fixed plexus. In some cases, T1 is absent, T4 takes part in forming the brachial plexus. This is prefixed brachial plexus. Trunk stage: C5, C6 joins to form upper trunk. C7 continues as middle trunk. C8 and T1 joins to form lower trunk. Each trunk divides into anterior and posterior division, anterior and posterior division, anterior and posterior division. So root stage, trunk stage, division stage. Next is the cord stage. The anterior division of upper trunk and the anterior division of middle trunk joins to form lateral cord. The anterior division of lower trunk continues as medial cord. The posterior division of upper trunk, the posterior division of middle trunk and the posterior division of lower trunk joins to form the posterior cord. So root stage, trunk stage, division stage, cord stage over. Now the branches. Branches from the root stage. Number 1, dorsal scapular nerve. It arises from the C5 root. Okay. Number 2, branch to phrenic nerve. It also arises from the C5. Number 3, long thoracic nerve of bell or nerve to serratus anterior. It arises from the C5, C6 and C7 roots. Branches from the trunk stage. In the upper trunk, there are 2 branches: suprascapular nerve and nerve to subclavius. There are no branches in the middle and the lower trunks. Branches from the cord stage. This is the lateral cord, this is the posterior cord and this is the medial cord. Branches from the lateral cord. Number 1, lateral pectoral nerve. Number 2, lateral root of median nerve. Number 3, musculocutaneous nerve. Once I will repeat: lateral root of median nerve, lateral pectoral nerve, musculocutaneous nerve. Branches from the medial cord. Medial pectoral nerve, medial cutaneous nerve of arm, medial cutaneous nerve of forearm, medial root of median nerve. So the lateral root of median nerve and the medial root of median nerve joins to form the median nerve. Branches from the posterior cord. Number 1, upper subscapular nerve. Number 2, lower subscapular nerve. Number 3, okay, thoracodorsal nerve. And number 4, axillary nerve. Number 5, radial nerve. So there are 3 branches from the lateral cord, 5 branches from the medial and posterior cord. Applied anatomy. Cruch paralysis. Injury to Cruch point results in Cruch paralysis. What is Cruch point? See, this area is the Cruch point. Meeting point of 6 nerves is known as the Cruch point. So what are the 6 nerves? Number 1, C5. Number 2, C6. Okay, anterior division and the posterior division of the upper trunk. And the 2 nerves arising, okay, suprascapular nerve, nerve to subclavius. So this point is the, okay, Cruch point. So injury to Cruch point results in Cruch paralysis. Cause. Number 1, breech delivery. Number 2, huge fall on the shoulder. So what happens? This results in, okay, damage to the upper trunk and also to the suprascapular nerve and nerve to subclavius. So what are the nerves mainly affected? Suprascapular nerve, musculocutaneous nerve and axillary nerve. So these are the nerves which arise from the C5 and C6. So muscles paralyzed, since the axillary nerve is injured, okay, deltoid is paralyzed, so abduction of the shoulder is lost. Okay. Since the musculocutaneous nerve is injured, okay, flexion of the elbow is lost due to paralysis of the brachialis muscle, and biceps is also paralyzed due to damage to the musculocutaneous nerve. So the supination is not possible. So the forearm is pronated. So in this condition, only the movement is up, okay, available below the wrist. So what happens? The arm is adducted due to the paralysis of deltoid. Okay, the elbow, the forearm or the elbow is extended and pronated due to paralysis of the brachialis and the biceps. Movement possible only below the wrist. So this is known as waiter's stiff hand or policeman's stiff hand. So condition, waiter's stiff hand or policeman's stiff hand. Number 2, Klumpke's paralysis. Okay, in this, usually the lower trunk is affected. Lower trunk is affected, especially the ulnar nerve is the main nerve which is injured. So in Klumpke's paralysis, what happens? There is a damage the muscles of the hands, intrinsic muscles of the hand. So this results in claw hand. Okay. In Klumpke's paralysis, since the C8 and T1 are affected, the sympathetic fibers passing through to the head and neck through the T1 are also getting affected. This results in Horner's syndrome, which includes the ptosis, anhidrosis and meiosis. Cruch paralysis. Okay. Due to pressure of the crutch, okay, usually the posterior cord is mainly affected. Especially the radial nerve is injured in this cruch paralysis. So injury to radial nerve results in wrist drop.